This is a single reaction. Haven't done one of these on YouTube, but I felt like today was a special occasion. I saw on my Twitter feed that Kendrick has released The Heart Part 5. You don't know much about the Heart series, do you?
Nope, don't know the Heart series.
So this is The Heart Part 5. I'm curious to see what it's going to sound like because we haven't really heard Kendrick's voice on a solo piece of work for like 5 years. So this is the
This is going to be cool in a few ways because it's like you just said, hasn't been, we haven't heard anything. I'm new to this, yeah. So I'm just going to shut up. But for you, you're going to be listening to it for the first time with me and you haven't heard something in 5 years.
Yeah. Yeah. I've heard him on features here and there, Baby Keem's album.
This is quite exciting actually.
Yeah. I'm very excited. Yeah. So, we'll get into it. I don't even know what to expect, so there's not much for me to say. If you guys want to see this reaction uncut, you can check it out on Patreon. It's available to all our Patreon tiers. You also get access to the Discord. Kendrick Lamar, The Heart, Part 5.
Oh, fuck.
Gotta turn this up.
Yeah, turn it up. That's fine. I'm gonna shatter those dreams, the culture.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I got back shivers, man.
Wow. That I do this for my culture. To let you know what a nigga look like in a bulletproof rover. In my mama's sofa. Repeats again. Make amends to find a nigga with the same skin to do it. But that's the culture. Crack a bottle. Hard to deal with the pain. In a land where hurt people hurt more people. Fuck calling it culture. Beat the drums out.
Magnified and persevered. Consciousness is synchronized and crystal clear. Euphoria is glorified and made his. To my brother, to my kids, I'm in heaven. To my mother, to my sis, I'm in heaven. But fulfilled my days, my I would swear Nile Rodgers is on this.
I know I was gonna say, I wonder who's doing the guitar work. Yeah. Just a hug, y'all. The memories recollect just because y'all. The energy that carry on and mix still. I want you. Hoo-hoo! Wow, you know, musically right now, there's something creepy going on. Okay.
How so?
I was upstairs talking to Grandma.
Yeah.
Okay. Grandma says to me, can you play some Donna Summer?
Yes.
Something I learned through you, through this whole process, was the Daft Punk album. Marauder.
Oh, yeah.
Giorgio
Marauder. And
right.
Produced some Donna Summer, right?
Yeah, produced. Yeah. He was a big producer of all that sound. Those strings in there right now, that
Nile Rodgers type guitar.
Yeah, the drums, that the disco feel there. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah, that was incredible. That is not what I was expecting at all. No. To be honest, like the second it started out, I had no idea like what direction it was going to go in. It could have been a more Baby Keem trap feel or something. Or to me, this sounds like his project, a little bit like his project, which you haven't heard, Untitled Unmastered, which came out after To Pimp a Butterfly. It was like some leftovers from To Pimp a Butterfly.
It had that sound?
Somewhat, like that's the closest thing I can put it onto, but it gives me a little bit of, you remember I off To Pimp Butterfly, the live interpretation of his song I that made the album, kind of gives me that kind of feel as well, a little bit, but not expecting this at all. And I have to say I'm completely blown away. I mean, especially with his just vocal delivery and his flow on this track. I mean, I didn't catch many lyrics at all because I was kind of grooving to it. I will definitely have to go and listen a few more times and read the lyrics. But I don't know. What do you make of it?
I like I said right in the song, man, I felt something special because I feel like I'm one of everybody else now.
Yeah, listening to something for the first time.
Yeah, I'm not behind. I'm not behind. I'm not like everybody's like, oh, I feel like fuck. That's a part of me now.
Yeah, that's kind of why I wanted to do this like right away. Like I was like, oh, it drops. Let's get downstairs. Let's film this.
That's cool. That's the coolest thing, man.
Because I remember my moments like that in music. Like, you know, I think of The Heart Part 4 when it dropped before Damn.
Yeah.
Or like when Kanye was doing his Good Fridays before The Life of Pablo. Or, you know, just any album. I think of the Radiohead one when the Burn the Witch video came out. Like all these moments are ingrained in my head.
Yeah.
As like these, you know, significant times for me, like, oh wow, I remember that. So I kind of wanted this to be one for you. You know, we're going to listen to The Heart Part 5 together.
Yeah.
And you'll, years down the road, you'll remember this. And
yeah,
you'll remember the album when we listen to it on Friday and your first reaction and the rollout and everything, that the hype around it. And it just enhances the experience, because it's really like a community thing.
Yeah. Know?
Like you see people all over the internet discussing it, breaking down lines.
Yeah. Of this?
See, like when you go on Twitter, people are going to be talking about The Heart Part 5. And then on Friday, they'll be all talking about the album and you'll be in that discussion. You know, you're not, you know, behind.
That's why I felt a part of it. Like,
yeah.
Right.
It's kind of like the closest comparison is it would be like you watching a TV show that aired, say, 10 years ago. And mm-hmm. then you're just kind of catching up and you get to a crazy episode and you're like, oh fuck, that's great, but you got nobody to talk to about it.
Yeah.
As opposed to watching a show and it's coming out week by week and you're up to date, and then you and all your friends are watching it together. And
well, yeah, that's why I'm like, right now I felt so cool when that came on, and then you just like I'm hearing it now.
We're both hearing it for the first time.
Yeah. It feels really cool, right? Friday is going to be, I don't know what I'm going to feel.
I'm very excited.
Like, it's crazy. Like, we're going to hear the whole thing together for the first time.
Yeah, with the viewers as well. And it's going to be...
Like, it's...
It's going to be, yeah, I don't know. I mean, we've done that a couple times with different albums, like Dawn FM, Silk Sonic. But I think this will be different because it's a Kendrick project.
We're doing it like it's been a week or what. Like, I find it so cool that we're doing it that night.
Yeah, that like it releases at 9. We'll be filming
at 9.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
I'm excited. And if that's anything what the album is going to sound like, then I'm even okay.
This
excited.
Is a question I wanted to throw your way here is that in the past with The Hearts,
mm-hmm.
did The Hearts always sound like the album, or was just this a throw off?
See, I don't, it's hard.
Cause I know you had the four.
It's hard for me to answer that. The one, I haven't listened to The Heart Part 4 in a while. One thing I remember, and correct me if I'm wrong, anybody watching this, but it had a few beat changes in The Heart Part 4.
Yeah.
And I know Damn had some beat changes. So, you know, there's that connection there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember if it sounded much like Damn. Because I really haven't revisited it since Damn released, because I listened to Damn after it came out, and then I never went back. And then I wasn't into Kendrick really when the older The Hearts came out, so I haven't really done my research there. So I don't know. To be honest, this could be a throw off, could be something that he's just doing for fun, or this could be the sound that he's going for. We'll have to wait till Friday to find out.
And you know what? Throw in the comments if you guys know the earlier stuff, right? Throw it in. Like, let us know. It'd be cool for me to know and Connor to know also. Like, some of the early... Is there part one, obviously, right?
Yes, there's one through five.
One through five. And then let us know if those that style on the releases of The Heart actually parlayed into the album, which would be... Or is it just a total, like...
Yeah. It's hard for me to answer that, just like, because I said I don't really remember too much of The Heart Part 4.
Because the production and the music on this one is right in my, you know, I was...
Oh, you were grooving.
The drums and everything, right, man. It's like, I want to listen to it right now again. The second time, we'll have to listen to it right after this.
No, that was fantastic. Did not disappoint me at all. Okay, I think we'll end off here. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to leave your comments just on your opinion of the song, and maybe if we miss something or if there's something you know that we don't know, we'd love to read it. You'll probably be reading the comments a lot for this video
tonight. I'm sure. All tonight.
So
Yeah. Thank you guys a lot. Like I said earlier, Uncut on Patreon if you want to check it out and you want to support the channel at the same time. And do you have any closing words?
No, I just want to just send out all the love to everybody's mothers out there and mothers that are not with us anymore, new mothers, and just love you guys all, man. Make my mom, your mom, big, you know, parts in our life, and we love the mums.
We are mother lovers.
We are mother lovers. Is that a song?
Yeah, it's a Lonely Island song. I think. Something about mother lovers. Okay. Anyway, see you guys.
Okay, bye-bye. Peace.